Virtual desktop has been the de facto standard for being able to play PC VR games wirelessly on your Oculus Quest for years. The process for this has been somewhat convoluted though, with the need to become an Oculus developer, sideload patches, and a number of other steps needed to get it up and running. Now, however, with the latest release of Virtual Desktop, that has all changed. It is now super simple to get up and running in no time at all. So in this video, I'll be covering what's changed, what are now the super simple steps that you need to get Virtual Desktop set up on your Quest and your PC, and take you through how to play your first game. Welcome to my tech gear, let's get into it. Before we go any further, if you do enjoy the video, please don't forget to like and share it. And if you're not subscribed yet, then consider hitting that subscribe button down below and hitting that notification bell so you're notified about new videos as and when I release them. It really helps me build up my channel so that I can keep making videos like this for you. Thanks. Virtual Desktop is an awesome app that allows you to play wireless PC VR games on your Quest headset. However, since its launch, Oculus has required this feature to be disabled in the Virtual Desktop app that is available in the main Oculus Quest store. So in order to get around that, Guy Godin, who's the developer of Virtual Desktop, released a patch for it on SideQuest that you could install that re-enabled this feature. That meant that the steps required to get this set up was pretty laborious though, because you had to enable developer mode on your Oculus account, set up SideQuest, and also install additional drivers on your PC in order for this to work. With the latest release of Virtual Desktop though, this feature has been added back into the main app that is available on the Oculus Quest store, so you no longer need to do any of that. This now makes being able to play PC VR games wirelessly super simple. Having just made a step-by-step video guide though on how to do this a couple of weeks ago, well, that's a little bit annoying because now all those steps are now all wrong. So here's this video that takes you through all the new, even simpler steps needed to get set up. So let's just get straight into the steps that you need to do to get your Quest set up. So the first thing you need to go and do is buy Virtual Desktop on the Oculus Quest itself. So go into the App Store of the Oculus Quest and just buy Virtual Desktop. It's $19.99 US at the moment. So now that we've got the client set up on the Oculus Quest headset itself, we now need to set up the server or the streaming app on the PC. And that's really easy to do. All you need to do is go to vrdesktop.net, which is what's running behind me, and download the streamer app from that main page that you see behind me. Once you've done that, install it and then run it. What you'll be presented with is a single page app, and that really is all there is to it. The only thing you need to do on that main page is insert your Oculus username on the top left hand side. Now, if you don't know what your Oculus username is, it's actually really easy to find. In the Oculus app that's on your phone, if you click on the picture of your account, which is normally on the top left, and then the next page, it will show you what your username is underneath that same picture. So with that username, just copy it to the top left, and that's the server side of it all done. So now you're all set up and ready to play your first PC VR game wirelessly on the Oculus Quest headset. Now before we do that, it is assumed that you've got some PC VR games already installed on your PC from either the Oculus Rift or the Steam VR stores. If you haven't got either of those set up yet, then be sure to check out my video of the easy step-by-step guide of how to get both of those set up. So you go over there, follow those steps, install some games, and then you'll be ready to go for the next step and come back here. Now that you've got all your games set up and ready to go, we're ready to play our first game. First up, you need to make sure that both your Quest and your PC are on and they are connected to the same network within your house. Now you need to go and run the VR Streamer app on your PC. Then, on the Oculus Quest headset, select Virtual Desktop from your app library. This will start the Virtual Desktop app and will automatically find the Streamer app that is running on the same network on your PC, and it will automatically connect to it. Once that's completed, you should be looking at the screen of your PC within your Oculus Quest headset. Now, if you click on the Oculus button on your left controller, this will bring up the Virtual Desktop menu, and you'll see settings and a few other things. If you select on games, it will show you the list of PC VR games you've got installed on your PC, so either the Rift games or the Steam VR games. Just select the game you want to play, and voila, it loads and we are done. You are now ready to play your first PC VR game wirelessly from your Oculus Quest headset. Do let me know in the comments down below how you got on. What was the first game you tried? What games are next on your list? By the way, I can thoroughly recommend Half-Life Alyx if you haven't tried that game already.
And there you have it, super simple, up and running in absolutely no time at all. It is great that Facebook have allowed this feature back into the main virtual desktop app, as I'm sure this will see a lot more people giving wireless PCVR gaming a shot. With SideQuest no longer being required to get virtual desktops set up, it is going to be interesting to see what the impact this has on its usage in the long term, as it's often the main reason that people get SideQuest in the first place. I'd certainly still encourage people to use SideQuest though, as it's still the best single source available to get apps and games for the Quest outside of the official App Store. It's also the best place to be able to get games from App Lab, which is Oculus's new early adopter app store. It's just not easy finding those games at the moment on the main Quest store, and it's way easier finding them on SideQuest. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video and I hope it was helpful to you. If you did enjoy it, please don't forget to like and share it. If you're not subscribed yet, button down below. And as always, see you in the next one.